Hi, welcome to my next video. This time I wanted to show you something a little bit different, at least at the beginning of the video, because I wanted to show you the event we held, the signing event we held in Shinjuku in the Kinokuniya main store, which is one of the biggest bookstores in Shinjuku in Tokyo. So I had a signing event there in the evening for the Tokyo Storyfronts book, and not just any Tokyo Storyfronts book, because I did a special cover for this shop only. So I painted this Kinokuniya main store, the building, because it is registered as an architectural asset for Tokyo, and they wanted to do a special version of the book cover for the Tokyo Storyfronts book that will be available only in this store, in this chain of stores. So you could buy the book and get it signed by me during this event, and Kana took a lot of awesome footage during that event, so I wanted to show some of it to you. The event took place in the evening because it was still really hot in Tokyo at that time, so we tried to avoid being in the direct sunlight, and it was actually good because I spent about 2 or 3 hours just talking all the time and drawing in people's books and showing what I'm drawing on the television screen that was on my left hand side, so everyone could see what this event is actually about. And I was really happy at the event, and it was really exciting because a lot of people turned up and they bought the special edition of the book to get my sign in it, and I ended up signing so much books that my hand hurt actually. So a total success. But before the event, I had to actually make the cover for the book, so make the illustration that we'll get on the special edition of the book. And by the way, I don't know, but maybe you will still be able to buy the special Kinokuniya edition of the book in Japanese Kinokuniyas, or if you are outside of Japan, just ask in your Kinokuniya if they can get it for you. But only the cover is different in this edition. Okay, so in the making of this illustration, the first step was to do a sketch in Procreate. I wanted to get the shape of the building straight right, so I did a quite detailed sketch in Procreate and then colored it too also in Procreate, so I have a nice sketch that I can send to the Kinokuniya people and also to the publisher, so I can get it accepted and start with the manual work. I tried to keep it in the style and making method as close to the original Tokyo Storyfront series as I could, so I used the same paper and also the same rotring isograph pen, the 0.5mm thickness for the lines. In the end, of course, this shop is a lot bigger than the ones I did for the original book, so the details got a little bit smaller and everything got kind of compressed in the finished cover, but I think I did alright for such a big store and modern like concrete structure to make it kind of nice and colorful and appealing for the cover. I also put a lot of effort to kind of recreate the entrance because it has a lot of things going on there. There's like a small marquee for events, that's where I actually held the signing event, moving stairs up, entrance to the basement below, and you can go also to the metro through there. There's the cafe in the upper right corner, so there's a lot of stuff there, and I wanted to be as accurate as I could with this. Also, I tried very hard to recreate the lettering on the sign of the store because it's really important, it goes to the actual owners of the store, so I wanted to make it as realistic as possible, so I spent some time trying to get the letters right and all the signs and all the posters and to get just the kind of atmosphere of a bookshop that is doing a lot of things right now. Also, the top part of the building was quite a challenge because of lots of windows that I had to paint to look like three-dimensional and like things are kind of reflected in them. I used some masking fluid here to protect the white of the paper in the places that I wanted the whitest reflections on the windows. So I painted over it with kind of saturated green and blues, being kind of sure that I have the white of the reflections and the lights inside of the building protected by the masking fluid. I painted the whole thing using my Schmincke Hordam watercolors, the professional watercolors from Schmincke, and this is a set of 50 colors that I made myself, and you can see the set in one of my videos. This was painted based on some photos that I took in Shinjuku myself, so I went with camera and just took some photos, especially of the details of the entrance that are very small and are kind of hard to see on photos that you can get of the building from the internet. And I also got some photos provided by the Kinokuniya staff, so I could see some photos that they took of the building on various occasions. Overall, I thought that this picture would be kind of boring to do because this is just one of the kind of high-rise office-like buildings in the middle of Shinjuku, so you kind of go past it and you don't really look at it and you cannot really see a lot of it because it's so high. But in the end, I really enjoyed painting this picture. It has so many colorful details and I kind of tried to make it colorful on purpose. And the staff of Kinokuniya also liked it very much and they were really happy that they can have the version of this book with their shop on it. Okay, so this is how the finished illustration looks like. It was used on the special edition of the Tokyo Storyfronts cover. Okay, that's it for this video. I hope you liked this kind of half video blog, half making of video. As always, feel free to comment, share and subscribe, and you can also support me on Patreon. It's your support on Patreon that allows me to do this kind of personal projects. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video. Bye!